ladies and gents. I'm Ruth Delgado, and this is Ruth Delgado's Diamond Page here. Sorry for the smoke. I had to put this on, and I don't know, it always happens where it just, no matter how much I take the hair out, it just keeps smoking. So, that's what that is.
If you guys are wondering, nothing's on fire.
But, that's to let you guys know what I'm going to be doing today. And what I'm going to be doing today is this mannequin doll's head. So I'm going to flat iron and probably do a little cute style with her hair. I'm going to get it as straight as I can, but I'm not too sure how straight that's going to end up being, but we'll see. I could bring you guys closer, but I really want a good angle. So here's her hair and her texture already. It's pretty frizzy. So we're going to do what we can to do something about that. First, I'm really trying to find a better spot to put you guys at. Because honestly, I really don't want y'all there. That's not gonna work. Needs to be closer. So it looks like I'm gonna have to do it this way. Okay. Let's see, guys. So, can you come down some? For right now. Because this attachment right here does not stick to the table at all. I tried to use a weight, my boyfriend's weight, to keep it down, but I don't know, it's still kind of moving a little bit. And I really don't feel like standing up right now, so forgive me if, you know, it probably was better view standing. Actually, it looks like it's better view sitting down, to be honest, anyway. But I don't know if I'm going to be able to have her in my lap while I'm using the hot tools. I don't think that's a good idea. So, but we'll see. Alright, so what I'm going to do first, what I'm going to do first is section her hair up into four sections. So, don't even have a mirror here to actually get a better view, but we're going to work with what we have. Next time I do a hair video, I'm 9 times out of 10 probably going to get in front of the mirror. But I just can't do that today. But I'm going to keep that in mind. Because that way I'll probably be able to get a better angle for myself. Alright, I'm trying to make this straight, but it really don't have to be straight. I'm just trying to make it straight because I'm doing the best that I can to get better at my parts, because sometimes I get my parts great and then sometimes my parts be a little bit off. So I've been doing the best that I can to like really practice with my parts. Basically, I was just talking about this recently to my boyfriend. I was like, you know, we've been kind of conditioned to constantly like be afraid of like messing up and making mistakes, and I'm like, people don't even understand that you shouldn't allow yourself to be afraid to make mistakes. If anything, you should basically make the mistakes but ensure that you don't make them in vain. In other words, make the mistakes, but make sure that you learn from them. Make sure that you find out what you're making the mistakes in, and then hone in on those mistakes and those causes of the mistakes, and figure out how you can get to the point that you're not making mistakes anymore, because you perfected the imperfection that you noticed that you were causing yourself. That's what should be taught, not don't make mistakes. What should be taught is, if you do make mistakes, all right, no big deal, it's not the end of the world. Let's find out what was the mistake. What could you have done differently that would have put you in a more beneficial situation? And when you find that out, you keep practicing. So that's why I decided to keep practicing when it came to my parts, and do the best that I can to make my parts a lot straighter, a lot more accurate. So that, like, when I do styles like twists and braids and stuff like that, it looks a lot more uniform and a lot neater. Because a lot of times, the cleaner your parts are, the neater the style that you're doing in the hair is going to look. Guys are wondering, what is she, a hairdresser or something? If maybe you haven't seen any of my other hair videos, no, I'm not a hairdresser right now. To be honest, I never planned on being a hairdresser, even though I have went to cosmetology school. No, I have not graduated as of yet, as of today, but I will go back and graduate. That is a part of my goal. But at the moment, I have to get some other things, some other goals accomplished first in chronological order, to be able to secure myself a lot better this time in my future and focus a lot better in school. So I have to secure some things and situate some things before I can actually make that happen. So that's why I'm not back in school yet, so that I can finally graduate. Because whether I go back to cosmetology school and graduate, and or community or another college, I don't have a lot of time frame that I need before I can graduate. I have actually gotten a lot of my credits already, whether it be in regular college or in cosmetology school. So I already know by the time I do go back, it's like 6 months, if that, for the cosmetology school for me to be able to graduate. And it's like probably a year, 2 years left for me to be able to get all of the credits that I need to graduate college. So that's why I'm like, you know, first of all, I don't ever want to start something and not complete it. That's one reason why I want to go back to school eventually. But I also want to go back eventually because I would like to get my credentials. And get people to be able to see on paper how decent I am and how much I have worked on myself and my craft. All of my crafts, whatever it be. So that's another reason why I'm like, I'm definitely gonna go ahead and go back to school, but right now I have a lot of things in motion that I need to secure. And until I do that, I gotta chill with school for a minute. But I definitely have no problem with learning. You know, I actually enjoy learning. Learning new things, you know, meeting new people, getting introduced to new environments, new ways of thinking, new ways of moving. Because I honestly feel like a lot of times people limit themselves by not learning new things, not educating themselves consistently. I mean, I feel like even people that graduate from college still are never fully, completely finished school. Because if they're a person that prides themselves in constantly learning and growing and moving forward as long as they're alive, then they would know, like, even after college, trade school, whatever, you can never learn all there is to know in the world. But you can do the best that you can while you're in the world to teach yourself, to school yourself, and to make sure that even though you didn't always know, make sure it's never a time that you never gonna know. Make sure that you make it possible that you will know eventually. Once you get there, you're gonna get yourself there. So that's where I'm at in my head. I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna get myself where I wanna be. But it's just gonna take time. And I have to be patient with myself and my progress. And I have to understand that it's important to have this patience with myself if I want to actually become a success. I understand that. It's a little hard sometimes, but sometimes it's a lot hard, but it is what it is. All right, guys. So, as you guys can see, turn camera around for you. Looks like I still need to bring it up some, because you really can't even see the top of her head. But anyway, until I can find something else, which I think I just found it. Hold on. See, I got this, y'all. I got this. Practice makes perfect. So, there it is. Alright, y'all. So, I'm not going to be doing too much with too many different products because I don't want to kick her hair up with a bunch of products. Because honestly, I just did not feel like washing her hair before I did this. So, that's why I said that I don't know how silky smooth it's going to become. I'm going to do the best that I can. My little skills. So yeah. So the only two products that I decided to go ahead and use today on her hair, even though her hair is kind of stiff already, is Chi products with keratin mist. Let's spray a little of that on there. And oh, that smells good. Also, trying to be careful, y'all, because I don't want this to fall on my feet, no. So, got that product on there already, that section. And the next product I'm going to be using is smoothing balm. It's like a silk keratin type situation. So, I'm going to put a little of that on there. Smooth it through. Real good. That smells good too. Everything smells good, child. I be trying to do the best that I can to make sure I get stuff that smells good. And I be so happy when it's a success. Because I hate having, like, anything that don't smell good. But, like, especially hair products and stuff like that don't smell too good. I be like, ugh. I don't like that. I really don't. So, I'm going to use these clips to put that up. And I'm going to use, this is a product that I already used on here. So if you're already a part of the Truth Chart, you probably already know. You probably already see me use it. But this is what they call a straightening brush. I don't know why it took a moment for me to realize that. But anywho, it's called a straightening brush. But the cool thing about this is that you can use this on hair wet, and it dries the hair, and it doesn't like shock you or hurt you or burn you or anything like that. That's the cool thing about this. That's why I love this right here. So I'm using this because her hair is kind of like crinkly and poofy. So I'm using this to do the best that I can to make it as smooth and as straight as possible. So you guys see that? Nice, right? I'm trying to do the best that I can to get as close as I can to the roots. One issue that I have noticed about this, that's not the best thing, that's why I always have to use two tools when I use this, is that it's very difficult, especially on a real person's hair, it's very difficult to get to the nape of the neck and get to the roots. It's really kind of complicatedly hard sometimes. But beyond that, y'all see it. It's nice and straight and smooth. Okay, so we're going to take the next section. I'm going to make the next section. Well, part, actually. This whole thing is a section, but this is the part. So we're going to make the next part. And pin that back up, flip it, like that. And take the comb, smooth it out as much as possible. Trying to make sure that this hair is as smooth as can be, like smooth as a baby's bottom, smooth and silky. Yes, yes. So, if you guys are wondering, so can you do these same types of hairstyles that you be doing on a mannequin on a person's head? Yeah. To be honest, y'all, besides like stuff like what I just had to deal with, like this lifting up, what was I saying? No, actually the other way around. Doing it on my head or on a person's head is a lot easier than, you know, creating looks on the mannequin, because like I said, with this lifting up and adjusting and moving around when I don't want it to, and stuff like that, kind of makes it a little frustrating. But what does make it easier is I don't have to worry about burning her because she's not actually a person, and I don't have to worry about burning myself because it's not my head. So that's good. I don't have to be super careful, but if y'all notice, I usually naturally am super careful, because when I did go to cosmetology school, I was doing actual people's hair, and I do the best that I can because I hate to get burnt myself. I do the best that I can not to burn people when I'm doing their hair. And so, yeah, so like when I was in school, I was actually doing people's hair, and even when I wasn't in school, but like I had people around me who would like let me, you know, practice on their head. And no, I never messed nobody's head up either. Because some people will be like, did you mess up somebody's head? No, I didn't. Never messed up nobody's head. The only head that I ever messed up, and I ain't really even messed that up, is my head. I remember one time, I was taking out some braids. I'm not sure if they was individual braids or if they were like, the kind of braids that's like, you know, like straight backs, because hello. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Sorry, y'all. Had to get that just in case he actually needed something. Anyways, what was I talking to you guys about? I don't even remember now, because the phone ringing distracted me. But, Oh, that's what I was saying. The one time that I did, like, kind of like mess up my hair, but not really. I had got some braids. Like I said, I'm not sure if they were just like the straight back cute braids or if they were like individual braids, but I had some kind of braids in my hair, and I had got like so tired of taking the whole long behind braid out to the point I decided, okay, you know what? I'm gonna cut it because I'm tired of taking a whole long, like it was long braids, like long like this, or probably a little longer than this. And I was just like, I'm tired of taking a whole braid out. Let me just cut it down. That way, I'm not taking an entire super long braid out. Why'd I do that? Because now I know how to cut it right to the point where I don't cut my hair. But at that point, I didn't know how to cut it right to the point I cut my hair a little bit a few times. And I had was snipping away because I was trying to get done. Because I was like, it was taking so long. My arms was tired. Like, if you ever took your own hair out by yourself, then you know what I was going through. I've also braided my own hair in individuals, and my arms, you get tired and stuff like that. But that was the one time that I did. I had snipped out probably like 6 different braids, and I recognized when they fell to the floor. I was like, oh my gosh, I cut some of my hair. Yeah. But of course it grew back. But yeah, I did that before. But other than that, I've never really like done anything that ever messed up anybody's hair, including my own. Like, I never even gave myself a bad cut besides that. So I'm pretty proud of myself on that, you know. And the clients that I had, as well as the people that I worked on when I was in school, did not have any complaints at all. And I'm being honest, like I had a lot of actual people telling me that I did a really good job and they loved my work more than anything. Never had any negative complaints about when I did hair. So that's something to be proud of. Especially knowing that I never messed up my own hair either, because yes, I have been a little ballsy, if you will, and decided a few times to color my hair, and it turned out well. Like, I actually got scared one time because I had let a hairstylist that I actually was working with color my hair, and she told me it wasn't bleach, but it was. She lied to me. So I had this fear of putting bleach in my hair before I had ever did it. And this was before she put the bleach in my hair and told me that it wasn't bleach. So I had told her about it. I told her, I said, you know, I'm really scared to put bleach in my hair. I don't want my hair to come out. I don't want my hair to get messed up. So she was like, oh, I have something else that's not bleach and it does the same thing. The girl lied. It was definitely bleach. But anywho, it turned out really pretty, even though it wasn't the color that I really wanted it to be. It was like an orange red. I really wanted it to be like a red red. How it came out. I mean, well, no. I didn't even put the color in it yet. She had just bleached it. And it came out like an orangey red. And I mean, I kind of like that color now, but I just felt like it wasn't my fave then. Like, I had gotten used to wearing it once my hair was that color and I had to grow it out, but I wasn't used to it. So now if I was to, you know, get my hair bleached or whatever, I don't even think that I would wear my hair that color. I would just go ahead and put the color right in. I don't even know why I didn't put the color right in then. I think I was scared, because like I said, I was definitely kind of fearful of like over processing my hair with the bleach or something like that. So like, that's why I was like very careful. And thank God it worked out well, you know. Didn't mess my hair up, even though it was like an orangey look that I wanted more of a red look than an orange look. But it was like an orange red. It was like an auburn, but an orange auburn. If you know, you know. But yeah, so Y'all, if y'all wondering why I'm moving so slow, I'm trying to make sure that this weight don't fall on me. And I'm also trying to make sure the head and stuff don't fall on me. So if you're wondering, why is she doing it so slow? That's why. All right. So let's see if I can get that a little straighter because it looks so crinkly. Even though I am definitely going to take the flat iron and do this section. But I'm doing the best that I can to like straighten it as much as I can with this. So that it's just a smooth sail straight through with that flat iron. Real quick. So I'm not trying to be all day on this video. Okay. Hoping that it's just gonna be like an hour, if that. Sorry y'all, I had to take that phone call. Did I already apologize to you guys for that? I be like really apologizing for that because like I be feeling like it'd be so rude. To me, when people be talking to like different people and they on the phone with you, even though I'm not on the phone, I'm on, you know, YouTube, but still, same sense. So that's why I feel the obligation to really apologize, like I am, because I feel like that's rude. So yeah, I'm sorry y'all, but I had to answer because, you know, sometimes when you don't answer, you be mad that you didn't answer, you know. So I was like, let me just go ahead and answer. See what he's talking about. Nothing major. Okay. So now we have her first step straight. Okay. Now we're going to plug her in and do the second step straight. Yes, I have to do two steps. Not my favorite thing. Stand up for this one. Okay, so alrighty, y'all. You see it, right? You see it? Guys, if you're wondering, like, is she ever gonna do more than just styles on this doll's head? Yeah, I actually am. I plan to, but I need to get the bleach, and I have yet to do that as of yet. So I also have to find or get some new applicators and applicator bowls and stuff like that. Now I know I have some, but like I said, I gotta find what I already have and or buy some new stuff. So yes, I did just sit back down because my legs is bothering me because I've been keeping up on my exercising, guys. Have you guys been keeping up on your exercising if you keep up on my yoga dance? I've been keeping up on my exercising and my legs, my stomach, everything is sore. Only thing that's not sore is my arms, thank God, because I don't really work my arms out like that. And I had just decided to make the decision to start working my arms out, right? And then this happened. I'll explain this when I'm ready. Right now, I just don't even feel like it. And y'all, please excuse my nails. It's kind of cool that it's they match, even though those are gone. They are over there. I actually think I'm going to go ahead and put them back on. But right now, I just don't even feel like it. I didn't even feel like doing my hair. Like, even though my hair looks fine still, but I didn't feel like doing nothing. But I said, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get these videos done. I don't care about not feeling like that because I'm definitely going to get these videos done. So here we are and I'm getting them done. Aren't y'all proud of me? I'm proud of myself. I said, no more excuses. Ruth, we are getting things done. We're not making excuses anymore. And I have been strategically, purposefully making sure I don't make excuses anymore, and I'm so proud of myself. Thank you. Thank you, ancestors, for helping me, because it's hard. You're using your willpower and against yourself, it's hard, but you know, you gotta do it because it's for your own good. It literally is. It's like your parents having to like really come down on you, and you realizing, you know, when you're getting older that they're coming down on you because it's for your own good, you know? Sometimes you just have to keep that maturity that you had growing up. When you knew that your parents wasn't just telling you stuff just to tell you that. They were trying to help you, you know? They were trying to help you to recognize some things. They were trying to help you to grow and become a human being that is valuable to themselves and their surroundings. But the sad part about it is a lot of adults these days, sadly, don't have a lot of the skills that they should have. You know, just being mannerable people that are beneficial to each other and not users. You know what I'm saying? I feel like the world is full of a bunch of users nowadays, man. And it's so sad because they subject you to feel like you gotta use people too, because it's like all y'all wanna do is just constantly try to use people. Y'all don't wanna even think nobody. Like, people these days so disrespectful. You do something for them, they don't even wanna thank you. They don't even wanna say respectfully thank you. And I really be thinking in my mind, like, yo, who raised you to the point that they didn't at least make sure that you had common courtesy and respect to thank people when they do something for you? Because I'm pretty daggone sure those same people that have a problem with saying thank you will probably hit the bricks and be out so fast out of your life if you don't thank them when they do something. And that's what kills me, because it's like, how you gonna be like that? For real? Y'all, should I keep it straight or should I curl it? I ain't gonna lie, looking at it, I'm thinking about curling it. But I'm going to keep it straight for right now. Maybe I'll curl it in the next video. Because right now, that's silky. Silky, silky. It's a possibility because how slow I kind of got to go. First of all, to try to do the best that I can to show best results and take my time. But also how slow I have to go just to be careful that this contraption I have set up here don't fall on my feet or fall on my toes or to even fall on the floor. I don't even want it to fall on the floor because we live in apartments. I don't want our neighbor to start complaining. I ain't got time for that. So that's another reason why I don't want it to fall, because even if I do quickly move my feet, I don't feel like hearing them. Don't feel like it. So, all right, y'all. Looking silky, right? I ain't like. I see that? Movable. She can shake that hair and everything. So guys, I guess you're probably wondering, all right, so why'd you go to cosmetology school if you're not really planning on being a cosmetologist? Well, first of all, my mom signed me up for it, first and foremost. That's one reason why. And the other reason why is I actually have always had an interest in beauty and hair and nails and makeup and all that. So I do believe that's one of the major reasons why my mom signed me up for it, because she knew that I had an interest in it. And not only did I have an interest in it, I always had some pretty good skills that stood out from the crowd that showed that I actually, if I put my mind to it, would do really good in the business. So therefore, I believe that's another reason why she signed me up. for cosmetology school. And of course she's my mother, so I had to do what she told me to do anyway. That was another thing. Yeah. But what I originally wanted to do, to go to college for, was acting. That was actually what my major thing was, that I really felt like I felt free and happy and really like so many different really cool emotions when I used to act. Because short story time, my mom, if you guys are already part of the Truth Tribe, you already know, my mom was my teacher as well as the principal of her own school. And with that being said, I had opportunities to act in school. And I had those experiences where, you know, you went through the bloopers, you went through being scared to do it, then you went through practicing like crazy, and then being nervous to do the actual show, and then successfully achieve the goal of doing the show, and then seeing that it has become a success, and getting all of the compliments and everything after the shows, and people telling you how great you look up there and how good you sound and all of that type of stuff. Like, it was like a real high for me, I recognized, when I used to act. Like, it was like a whole process of highs, but it really was a serious high that I didn't get from anything else. And I still don't get the same high doing anything else as opposed to, you know, when I acted. Like, it was just so fun and enjoyable. Like, I definitely, one of the major things that I like about acting is basically being able to be free with my personality and adapt. I'm a very adaptable person. You know, I have a very, adaptable personality, the best way that I can explain it. So I feel like that's part of the reason why I can almost talk to anybody. Like, you know, put me in almost any surroundings and I can strike up a conversation with literally anybody. And I've actually tested myself on this and I've recognized it's actually true. Like, I really can talk to anybody. And I feel like I owe part of that to the side of me that's so adaptable and that knows how to adapt to another type of personality and character traits for a moment and put mine to the side. It's actually pretty fun and exciting to, like, for a moment, allow yourself to not be you and be free in what you want to do, but not have to be so pressured to be yourself. Allow yourself to be free to take on an entity or a character of someone else and be able to still portray your personality, but through them, therefore putting your twist on it, but at the same time having that experience of being someone else for a moment. It's, if you get it, you get it. But that's part of the reason, major reason, why I really always wanted to do acting, and I'm still going to do it. I just have to figure out how I'm going to accumulate it in my to-do list with everything else that I'm doing. But I'm definitely going to get back into it, because it definitely, I noticed that it nourished a side of me that I feel like for the longest time that I haven't been acting for, I felt like I'm kind of thirsty for it again. Like, I miss it, you know? I wish that I could act again. And I'm like, I can. I'm going to put myself in a position to be able to. And you guys, sooner than later, will find out how. Because I'm not going to let you guys in on every single thing. But you guys are definitely going to notice something new very soon, within the next month or two, where I start to accumulate more content that's a lot different from what I have been producing. But even though it's different, it will be very beneficial and interesting and fun and exciting, and I'm pretty sure you guys will really enjoy it. Let me just say that. So guys, stay tuned. I got a lot of stuff up my sleeves, even though I'm not even wearing any sleeves right now, but I have a lot of stuff up my sleeves for you guys. When I tell you guys I'm very creative, I don't speak lightly of that. Like, I'm always constantly thinking of new things to do, new ways to do things. Like, that's my motto, stay creative, you know? If you don't have anything else in this world, you have your creativity. And I used to want to be so many different things. I used to want to be an inventor when I was like real little. And I remember when I was studying inventing, and my mom was teaching me about it as well, because of course she knew that I was interested in inventing. So she, you know, taught me some things about it, and she told me, basically, she's like, you know what the mother of invention is? I'm like, what's the mother of invention? Necessity. She said, basically, everybody that has invented something, there was a necessity that was needed that made them put themselves in a position to be able to become a creator and invent something to supply the need of that necessity. And so when she said that, I was like, oh wow, that's cool, you know? So, you know, I still feel like I want to invent some things, but you know, I'm not really sure how I'm gonna go about that either. But you know, I just be brainstorming, because why limit yourself when God doesn't limit you, you know? God put us down here with so many, you know, unlimited opportunities and chances that we can give ourselves. All we have to do is prepare ourselves to be able to be prepared for those opportunities and those chances. Therefore, taking those chances by storm and actually becoming successful by doing that. 'Cause, you know, life is not about anything else but taking chances. And the more you take chances, the better you'll end up achieving your goals and being able to become a better version of yourself, because you're not scared anymore of the potential of what you can become. You recognize that that's your power, that you can change, and that you can change to exactly what you want to be, as opposed to change into something that somebody else is trying to make you become or make you be. So, as you guys can see, I've finished that one quadrant, and I'm on to the next one. Yes, I heard the door, but I'm busy right now. So either they're going to have to wait, or they're going to have to use their key. So, as you guys can see, that is so silky smooth on the other side. I love it. It almost makes me want to straighten my own hair now. Alright. Let me get this door. People want to irk me so much. Constantly. God darn it. You got a key. Use it. Sheesh. Sister is busy. Excuse me, y'all. So, anywho, if you guys are wondering, all right, why are you doing this section by section? One thing about especially straightening hair, especially black hair, if you don't take it small sections by small sections, you probably not going to have it very straight. So, that's why. And also, I do it small sections because that's how I was taught to do it in school. Because it's like easier to deal with, no matter how much hair your client has or the person whose hair you're doing. No matter what texture the hair is, it does make it a bit easier and simpler to just separate the hair in four quadrants and work on it that way as opposed to working on the entire head, having the hair all over the place, kind of unruly. It doesn't allow you to keep the same neatness and like valuable straight look that you want. And even though I'm doing this on a mannequin, I'm still showing y'all how to do it. So I'm still putting my best foot forward and making sure that I do it as though I would do it if I was doing somebody else's hair. So that you guys would be able to know how to do it right. So if you decide to do it, you know how to do it right. So smooth it on out. Bone straight, baby. Ain't no curl. No curl, girl. Okay. Yeah. Almost finished this quadrant, and then I will turn her head around so you guys can see how it's looking so far. It's looking pretty smooth, darling. Pretty smooth. Oh, excuse me, y'all. I totally forgot to put product on this side. How? I don't know. But anywho, let me put this up here and put some product on her hair. Totally forgot. I should have did just the whole back quadrant, but I think that's what I thought I did in my head. Totally skipped the whole step. Why y'all ain't telling me? But see, part of probably the reason why I've been going through this is because I've been getting distractions and getting phone calls and people coming in and stuff like that, so that's 9 times out of 10 why that ended up happening. Sorry, guys, if you guys were trying to really seriously take good notes. I'm sorry that, you know, that might have confused you a little bit. Like, wait a minute, why you didn't do what you did to the other side? My bad. My bad. I'm getting back to it. But I remember later. At least I remember. Okay. So we're back to the straightening brush. Sorry, guys. I totally forgot. But it's cool now. We're back to the regularly scheduled recording. Okay. So boom. Now we're back. Hopefully we won't get any more distractions. I am doing the best that I can to ensure that I get these videos done today. I am not playing with myself, y'all. You know, you ever hear that saying, don't play with your own potential? I'm not playing with my own potential no more, y'all. I'm not playing myself like that no more. I'm getting it together. Period. I'm not playing. Wrong one. I ain't playing, y'all. And I hope y'all ain't playing either. Do what you know you can. I mean, I know it's hard out here, especially if you're from the hood like I am. It's tough, you know? It's a bit difficult, but you live and you learn and you do the best that you can to create better circumstances and situations for yourself. So that you don't have to experience everything on your own by yourself. And you still have a chance to be able to become successful by learning through other people's mistakes sometimes. Because even though it's not a bad idea to make mistakes because you're going to learn from them as long as you open yourself up to learn from them. At the same time, you don't have to experience everything. That's one thing my mom taught me. Mom told me a lot, but that's one of the major things my mom told me. You don't have to experience everything. Sometimes you can definitely look at somebody else's experience and learn from that and say, you know what, I'm not going to do that. Because I see where it got you, and I'm not trying to put myself there. So, yeah, thank you for teaching me that. It's a lot of people that I feel that way about. Like, oh, thank you for showing me not to do that foolishness. So, as you can see, it's nice and silky smooth, just like the other side. Even though I kind of messed up a little bit at first. But we're back. Okay. Silky, silky. Gonna consume you with the straightening brush, nice and smooth with it. Smooth on out, and that's another reason why I'm moving slow too, y'all. Because that's another thing that I recognize. And when you want to make sure that the hair that you're working on is like super duper straight, you want to take your time, because that's how you can really smooth out all of the kinks. Okay. You can't really smooth out all of the kinks if you do not take your time, because some of those curls and kinks be a little stubborn, especially in real hair, like in a real person's hair. So you gotta take your time, baby. So that's another reason why, as you can see, if you noticed, I'm definitely moving a little slow. Slow motion for me. Slow motion moving for me. Slow motion for me. Yeah. Okay, so you guys can't see this side. But like I said, when I finish, I'm going to turn her around for you guys so you can see what we're doing over here. Because I don't have no way to put it over here for y'all to see it on the side. So. I gotta turn it around. Don't have a full view, but we're gonna work on that too. We're working on a lot right now, okay? If y'all wondering why I'm changing my voice, because I want to. You, I want to. That's why. So we got one more section after we're finished this one. Right here, right here, right here, right here. Nice and smooth, guys. Nice and smooth. The best that you can to get to the roots, but don't make a big deal about it because you're about to go right back through with the flat iron anyways, so it's really not that big of a deal. But we want her silky, so we're doing the best that we can to make sure she's silky. Silky smooth. Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Last row of this section, and then I think this is probably going to be a two different videos, because after this section is completed, I have some things that I have to do, so I have to bow out, but I will be back. I will return. Don't go nowhere, okay? Don't go nowhere. if and then.
First,
unplug that. And take it out of my way. And then we're gonna clip this up. But first, take that section out. Do that part, I mean. Clip it up. Ugh. Okay, guys, so we got that clipped up, and we're gonna section by section, I mean, parting by parting, glide this bad boy on down until it's nice and smooth. Okay, that's what we're gonna do, nice and smooth. Okay, got that. And smooth, guys. Make sure it's nice and smooth. Make sure you get to the roots. Because one thing you don't want, even though it's very hard when it comes to human hair, on an actual human head, one thing you don't want is to straighten your hair and still leave your roots super duper kinky. Because it's definitely a clear difference from the kinky or crinkly curliness to the straightness. It's a big difference. So I know it's hard to do, but when you're straightening hair, do the best that you can to get all the way to the roots, because those roots come through, baby. If you don't get them roots, they're going to show through. They're going to shine bright like a diamond. And you don't want that. So let's keep going. Gotta be careful with this, y'all. Got to be very careful. Very, very careful. Baby, don't get crazy. Okay. All right, y'all. We almost finished this quadrant, and y'all almost about to ready. Be ready to see what I just did. What I just did. Y'all finna see what I just did. Okay, we're already over an hour. We're not finished this section yet. OMG, I'm a little behind. Just a little bit. illegal.
Y'all wondering, don't that hair get hot on your hand?
Yeah. When it gets too hot, I will start using a comb to help burn it down, but
yeah, do.
Yep. But I done got used to it a little bit. I know one thing though, one thing about me doing hair, it really kind of made me sick and tired of doing hair, I'm not gonna lie. When I was like in hair school, when I was doing cosmetology and I was doing hair regularly, I got tired of even doing my own hair, child. And people who never took up cosmetology and stuff always got these little remarks, oh, I love to do my hair. Here's the thing. You've never had to do multiple heads in one day. So, of course, you love to do your hair. You only have one head. Even if that head is full of long behind hair, still, you only have one head. So, you only have one head that you have to deal with. How about deal with having 5 and 6 heads in one day? Or even 3 in one day? Like, child, you'd get sick and tired of you doing your own hair, too. But I've had people say that to me, like, oh, I don't know how you get sick and tired of doing your hair. I know how. I got sick and tired of doing my own hair, first of all, because my arms get tired. And I definitely was super sick and tired of doing my own hair when I was in cosmetology school, because I had, like I said, about, on a good day, 6 to 10 heads in one day, if it was a long day. So you do that much hair and then you tell me that you love doing your own hair, child, please, goodbye. Well, people love to make their little comments like you them, child, I mind you, you not me, don't do that. But people love to do it though, they do. Irk my life. But anywho, now I'm more into the vibe of doing it again, because I haven't really, you know, done hair like I used to for a while, so it's fun again. But I don't know, it seems like the fun is kind of taken out of stuff sometimes when you do it too much, or when you have to do it all the time. It becomes less fun, less exciting. I don't know why that is, but I have noticed that though.
You better stop.
Sorry y'all, gotta scare him because he be eating plastic. That's Plastic Cat over there. Sweeties is Plastic Cat. Plastic Cat is his second name. Now I gotta talk about you on YouTube. Now, so Plastic Cat, aka Sweetie, loves to chew on plastic. So if I have anything plastic where he thinks it's accessible, he's going to chew on it. So that's why I had to just yell at him just now to stop, because if I didn't, he'll make it, well, he probably already made himself sick by chewing on it already, but he'll make himself sick, and next thing I know, he'll be throwing up. So that's why I have to yell at him and tell him to stop that way. So don't be in my comments trying to tell me I'm being abusive to my cat. No, I'm not. My cat hard-headed sometimes. He need to be yelled at so that he can stop doing what's actually hurting him. He is a cat, so he doesn't understand it's hurting him. But because I understand it's hurting him, I have to yell at him. So don't be in my comments acting stupid. You will get yourself blocked. Just to let y'all know. If you didn't know, now you know. Alright y'all, like I told y'all, this is gonna be a two video
two part situation, because I'm about to shut it down for a minute because I gotta take a break. I told y'all my legs, and then my hand don't feel too great right now either. Like, hand getting a little tired. This hand that I hurt, so I gotta take a break, and then I'll come back to finish the other half of her head. Check her out. See how that hair is swinging? Look at that. All right. Silky, honey. Silky, silky smooth. Okay. Now let me turn her around so y'all can see her. You'll see her. Hold that. Move that out the way. You'll see her. You'll see her. She in motion, honey. Mobile. Alright. So, I will be back in the next video to do what I did to the back, to the front, and then style and show you guys how she comes out when she's fully, completely finished. So I'm going to zoom in a little bit. I see it. Nice and silky smooth. Nice and silky with it. Okay, we'll be back for the top part of the head and the styling. Later.